Going to be hard to find a much more beautiful city in the world to have a WTS triathlon. And with 12 degree water, 21 degree air, 65 plus men making their first WTS trip to Africa here in Cape Town. And Richard Varga along with Schoeman taking it out very quickly. Look at that pace. These guys are flying. Godoy into that bunch, not too much further back. The likes of Brownlee and Gomez, so the big boys all very tightly bunched. First time that we've seen the Italian team here. And if you take a look right there, Brownlee trying to get himself out onto that bike. It looks like a group of 13 or 14 men. So they have gotten a little bit of a breakout right now. And we'll see whether or not the two Russians along with the French team, and of course the big names. There on one side, the lead group of 14, the chase with Richard Murray, Mario Mola, Silva, and others. And there they are working very hard and very intelligently right now as the gap continues to get larger and larger. What was just a few seconds out of the water starting to move up towards the 1 minute mark. And Richard Murray and Mario Mola are gonna be in big trouble, I think, because there are some unbelievably motivated guys in this lead group. They don't wanna let them get close. And Gomez keeping the hammer down on that pedal along with Brownlee. These two guys have worked very hard and now they will come off the bike rewarded with about a 75 second lead over some of the big runners. Aaron Royal into this lead group, McCartney from Canada as well, Schoeman. But all eyes will in fact be, no question, on the lead bunch with Javier Gomez along with Brownlee. There's Murray back in the chase group, Mola and Sissons. That group of three are running very quickly, but I just can't see them making the podium no matter how fast they run. Brownlee taking a different strategy this week, trying to go a little bit faster and seeing if he can drop Gomez, but I don't think anyone right now is in this league. Javier Gomez, absolutely the complete package. He starts to run away. There you can see Polyansky, Dimitri in third place, but all eyes on Gomez for a victory here. He's been in some of the smaller African races, but he wins the WTS race. Brownlee for the second time in the season in second. And here comes Polyansky having his best performance in a bit of time as he gets onto the podium for a third place finish. What a great day of racing, but Javier Gomez gets it done one more time here in Africa.
Yeah, it was a pretty tough race. We worked a lot on the bike, especially Jonathan and I and some other guys. We wanted to keep the gap. We knew there were some very fast runners behind, and yeah, we just keep pushing and pushing. And yeah, the run, I didn't feel very fresh. I mean, I think we all were pretty tired and had heavy legs, but I just went as hard as I could on third lap, and I could make this little gap with Jonathan, and yeah, luckily I could keep it.